So someone's asking another interesting question. Oliver, I get what you're saying, but why Bitcoin? Why not another crypto? Well, let's look at it. Okay. Bitcoin came into existence in 2008. Okay. And we really don't know how it came into existence. We know a pseudonymous creator called Nakamoto Satoshi. We don't know if that's an individual or a group or an organization or a country or God. We really don't know. In the same fashion that we don't really know where gold came from, we don't have an originator. But gold has stood the test of time for thousands of years, despite not knowing how it's formed or the origin, how it comes into being. We don't really know. But what we do know is that there have been many, many metals that have been discovered after gold, that we know of after gold, and yet none of them has managed to replace the status, the level, the respect, the honor that gold has. Not silver, not copper, and not even things like palladium and things of that nature, despite maybe having a value greater than gold. Gold still has emerged from the metal metaphor as the king of the entire ecosystem of the metals. Okay? So gold has established itself as the king or the reserve asset of the metals ecosystem. Now let's move to Bitcoin. Since Bitcoin came into existence in 2008, there have been so far something like 7,500 attempts to duplicate it. Today, there are over 7,000 altcoins. Now, go all over the world and ask someone if they know Bitcoin versus another coin. And chances are they will have heard of Bitcoin, but not the other coin. Okay? In the multiple crashes or pullbacks, strong pullbacks that cryptos have had, on each pullback, slews of these thousands of coins have gone out of business. Yet Bitcoin remains as the reigning champion and king. The king of what? The king of the crypto ecosystem. No other coin, every other coin also has a creator. I think the fact that the creator of Bitcoin is not known is very important. I think the same way that the creator of all of our precious metals is really not known how it's done. How does the earth produce it? How does it come into existence? The institutional adoption is for Bitcoin. Bitcoin has emerged as the winner of the entire ecosystem, and no other coin has the security that Bitcoin has. Bitcoin is the number one, is probably the most secure asset in the world today. And so while I still believe that there are some of the coins like Ethereum that are going to make us a tremendous amount of money. I believe that. But when it comes to a store of value, when it comes to a legacy play, something you pass on that you never sell, That's not any other coin. Bitcoin, you never sell. Ethereum, we'll get in. We're going to play that, continue to play that. And we're going to sell that. We might even do better. But we'll sell it. But this is a whole different category. When you sell another coin, you will put that in Bitcoin. You will never sell Bitcoin. Not if I can help it. Two completely different worlds. I'm going to convince you to put your, what you make, what you gain, what you want to preserve. I'm going to try to convince you to put the majority of that into Bitcoin. You might go into the world and make something, but then where do you store what you've made? Bitcoin. You might grab a big score in Apple and cash out, but what do you do with what you've cashed out? Put it into the dollar? I'm going to try to convince you to put it into Bitcoin. Nothing has that place right now where it's going to store what you make, store the results of your energy, store the product of your hard work. What's going to store that? Bitcoin. Make it everywhere else in the world, but store in Bitcoin. That's what I'm going to try to convince you to do. And that's what separates it from everything else. A store of your value, not just a trade.